It is 6 stories high, can withstand a nuclear explosion, and costs more than $200,000 to operate. Air Force One is the most famous, and arguably, the most important aircraft. It is equipped with unhackable security, ultimate luxury, and the finest missile defense, so transporting the US president around the world is easy. However, getting inside is not an easy task. Remember the meticulous system and my words. It's little surprise that the media has called it the Flying White Mansion, given all of the fantastic high-end military features. So with seat belts fastened, let's have a peek inside. Before we take a look around the three-level cabin, we'll look at some of the aircraft's unique characteristics. Let's start with the plane itself. What is Air Force One exactly? Hello again! This is Ava, and welcome to another video on this channel. If you're new to this channel, please subscribe to be updated for more upcoming videos like this. Consider the usual Air Force One plane, the massive blue and white eye-catching superjet. To appreciate its uniqueness, you must look at the American flag on the tail or the gigantic United States of America encryption. There is nothing else quite like it, but there are some identical. That's because the White House possesses two similar Air Force One planes. They're both extensively customized Boeing 747-200B class planes with tail numbers 28,000 and 29,000 respectively. While Theodore Roosevelt was the first president of the United States to travel in an aircraft, the phrase Air Force One was not used until 1953 by President Eisenhower. But as we'll see in a moment, in 1962, John F. Kennedy became the first president to travel aboard a specifically designed presidential jet, a modified Boeing 707. Raymond Loewy, the plane's designer, picked the famous baby blue as a primary color since it was Jackie Kennedy's favorite. Of course, it matched the colors on the presidential emblem. Since then, the renowned wings have conveyed everyone from Barack Obama to Richard Nixon, Ronald Reagan, and Donald Trump, as well as everyone in between. The newest Boeing jumbo planes were first flown in 1991 under the George H.W. Bush administration. It should come as no surprise that modern jets are not inexpensive, given their superior security and comfort features. According to reports, an informal agreement was made with Boeing to restrict the price of two new Air Force Ones at $3.9 billion. Boeing had even declared that Trump had negotiated a terrific bargain. Still, the cost is far higher, according to the Defense Department's first written report. The Pentagon will have to pay $5.2 billion for the improved pair. The two planes have a similar construction to a standard commercial Boeing 747. They're huge, approximately 3 times the height of giraffes, and as long as a city block. Each plane has 4 engines, each producing 56,700 pounds of power and propelling the aircraft to a peak speed of over 700 miles per hour. Just 10% slower than the speed of sound. It can fly not just quickly, but also far on a single full tank of 53,611 gallons. These planes are capable of flying halfway around the globe. In addition, Air Force One travels more than the ordinary aircraft at 45,000 feet instead of 30,000 feet. Contrary to common belief, the Air Force One does not relate to this or any other Boeing. Air Force One isn't a plane. It's merely a moniker and a point of reference. If the president were to fly in an F-22 Raptor for the length of his trip, the Raptor would become the new Air Force One jet. It doesn't have to be a cargo jet or a luxury Boeing. If he were in a B-2 Spirit stealth bomber, it would be the new Air Force One. Get that? The name is merely the radio call for any presidential Air Force vehicle. This is communicated to all crew members and air traffic controllers to avoid misunderstandings with other planes in the region. In this way, the president's plane safety may always be emphasized. In addition, an Army aircraft is referred to as Army One. In contrast, a Navy aircraft is referred to as Marine One. The naming system was originally employed during the Eisenhower administration, when the jet carrying the president carried the same sign as a commercial flight operated by Eastern Airlines. They were flying in the same airspace, necessitating the development of a new and improved system. Unlike a standard Boeing 747, presidential transport planes are equipped with three different floors. However, as you'll see, the interiors of the Air Force One planes have little in common with commercial 747s. Working from the bottom to the top, the lowest level is usually used for freight, the middle level for the primary passenger area, and the higher for complicated communications equipment. No doubt, freight room and equipment storage are vital. Still, the passenger area is the most fascinating, making most homes appear tiny. The plane's onboard living spaces include the president's bedroom, bathroom, fitness area, and office. As if that wasn't enough, most of the furnishings are handcrafted by professional carpenters to the president's specifications. A big meeting room that serves as the president's dining room is the centerpiece of the middle level. Senior staff members have their work area, and traveling reporters also have their section. The massive jet can accommodate up to 70 passengers and 26 crew members. Unfortunately, even visiting politicians and high-level media are denied access to various portions of the jet, despite our reasonable grasp of the arrangement. This implies that, except for a rough description of what's inside the jet, no one but the president and his team knows how these components go together precisely. We know that the president will not be served a stale bag of salted peanuts for lunch. The crew provides 24-hour first-class service on board the jet, including a delectable high-quality meal. Devoted cooks produce anything the president desires, including unusual recipes or good old-fashioned fast food. Do you doubt us? See for yourself. Previous diners have featured anything from KFC chicken to Caesar wraps, steaks, tacos, salads, and fresh salads. You name it, a professional chef can prepare it. The team can feed around 100 people at a time, and the storage facility can keep up to 2,000 meals. Unlike typical aircraft meals, the White House crew must choose markets randomly, do grocery discreetly, and never source from the same site twice when purchasing presidential foods. This was done to safeguard the president from a planned poison assault. If something goes catastrophically wrong, the Air Force One is equipped with all necessary equipment at 45,000 feet in the sky. A fold-out surgical table, a defibrillator, oxygen, and more are all available in the specialized medical area. Of course, having the technology is useless if no one understands how to utilize it effectively. That's why a permanent staff doctor follows the president everywhere he travels. The plane is equipped with cutting-edge communication devices in case something goes wrong. However, the primary purpose of the vast electronics is to, you know, run a nation. There's no time to appreciate the vista above the sky when you've over 331 million people under your wing. To keep up with what's happening on the ground, the planes are equipped with 19,000 televisions, 85 telephones, a collection of secure two-way radios for backup communication, fax machines, and super high-speed onboard Wi-Fi. With all these tools in place, the president can reach almost anyone globally at any time. Suppose he doesn't want to make the calls? One of the adequately checked military men on board will. Air Force One usually has a crew of 26 people, all of whom must work with extreme security and expertise. Every member of the staff chosen from the military must pass a thorough background check and have exceptional service records. This is no ordinary job. So the president's final Air Force One flight is typically an emotional excursion when he has to say goodbye to his 4-year-plus staff. Another unique feature of Air Force One, which distinguishes it from regular planes, is that it does not require airport infrastructure. And having no touch with airport personnel implies significantly fewer security risks. The aircraft have their retractable stairwells and luggage loaders with 3 entrances in case one is damaged. While other flights must stop every several hours to refuel, the presidential plane, theoretically, never has to land because of its incredible capacity to refuel in mid-flight. In an emergency, this is especially important when the threat is land-based. Sure, it's a necessary safeguard, but it's also prohibitively expensive. According to a Freedom of Information request, Obama's Air Force One cost taxpayers precisely $206,337 every airborne hour. So a regular New York to Los Angeles flight costs almost $1 million. But why is the price so high? First, the 26-person crew must be compensated. Then there's the fuel. The 4 engines use around 5 gallons of gas every mile. This takes the anticipated gasoline expenses per hour to a shocking $80,000. Not to mention the cargo planes that must convey the presidential limousine, the 3 following helicopters, and the 2nd Boeing that must join the trip in case the first one fails. So you can see how quickly the figures pile up. Fortunately, the chances of something wrong occurring to that plane are nil. Why? Because it has some of the most cutting-edge avionics and defense systems available. The aircraft can fool enemy radars and release white-hot flares to divert heat-seeking missiles. If the rockets are infrared-seeking, infrared countermeasure jammers, which are special infrared light, can be used to jam and deflect them. Air Force One can not only deflect any surface-to-air missile and withstand bullets owing to protected glass, but it can also be ready for this with its specially coated shell and survive the devastation caused by nuclear weapons on the land below. So if things start to fall apart, the president may take shelter in the skies. If an emergency scenario arises, or if the president merely wants to go to Hawaii for a vacation, there is significantly more preparation and logistics behind the scenes than most people think. Before the trip, skilled Air Force workers at the Maryland Andrews Air Force Base thoroughly check the jet. Once the all-clear is granted, the Marine One helicopter carries the president from the White House to the Air Force Base. At the same time, troops maintain a close lookout for any unauthorized aircraft threats, and yes, they are allowed to fire on the spot. The Air Force assures that the president's ground transportation will be ready and available upon his arrival by dispatching several cargo planes just before the presidential Boeing takes off, transporting the prison's bulletproof weapon-loaded motorcade. Is it too pricey to keep this aircraft in the air for $200 per hour? Please share your opinions in the comment section and don't forget to subscribe. This is Ava. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.